was asked to be his girlfriend over text. I was very excited to say yes. He replied with, I was afraid you'd say that. I just really don't want a girlfriend at the moment.
Why put it out there?
That's so funny. Hey, do you want to be my girlfriend? I would love to.
I was worried you'd say that.
I was worried.
That's why single feels good. Please welcome Brittany Hockley and Lauren Burton.
I don't know what was worse, listening to that breakup text or listening to my laugh where I'm hyperventilating. The laugh is my favourite part.
You're taking your Life Uncut podcast on the road. How are you feeling about the live shows? Being out there, right in front of fans, who's got the most nerves?
I feel equal parts excited and terrified. I know Britt's going to say that I will. I'm well known for needing to go and very last minute go and do a nervous poo, and I'm getting in there because I know Britt will say it anyway. Just like, you know, you've got to make sure nothing happens on stage that you don't want to happen.
I actually was not going to throw you under the bus there, but you did it yourself.
That's a hell of a plug for the live show. You get more than you expected with the ticket price.
100%. No, I think... we're so used to recording, like, with no pants on at home, just doing it, just, like, really cash. But I think it's definitely more nervous when there's thousands of people in person. But you're more excited than nervous, so we're super pumped.
All right, you're dating experts. We're a news show. I wanted to get your insights on some dating icks. This came from a survey of 1,000 people who listed the top icks in their lives, and they include too much talking about an ex, having poor table manners... and being rude to waitstaff. Do you agree with those icks, and would you like to add any more?
Waitstaff is a big one for me. If you're rude to a waitstaff, or, I mean, anyone, it doesn't have to be waitstaff, but for me it's like instant dismissal. I'm out of there. I'd probably eat 3 courses and then get out of there. but the other thing for me on a date, a food date, like a dinner date, is chewing with your mouth open. If I can see what you are eating...
No, I reckon worse than that is, you know when, like, someone's eating pasta and then they have all the little red bits for the sides of their mouth?
Oh.
Just sitting here?
Oh.
That's
we've
it.
Been guilty of that.
That's a bit harsh.
What? If someone puts... Yeah, imagine sitting there across from your date and your date's talking to you and they've just got little red Heinz sauce
but
in the corner.
That's not an coagulation.
Or they put something really hot in their mouth and then they're like, wow.
You know what? It's really hard to date Laura.
Yeah, wow.
Lucky she's spoken for now, huh?
Yes.
What about blokes that clap, applaud when the plane lands? That's a bit ickish, isn't it?
What's wrong?
Well, I mean, if you're flying Ryanair, it's okay, right? Doesn't everyone do it on Ryanair?
But then also, is it that bad to give the pilot some validation for a good job? Maybe not.
Mm. If he's the only one doing it, then yeah, ick.
Girls, I'm sure you saw Taylor Swift made headlines recently by attending her new boyfriend Travis Kelce's football game with his mum. What are your thoughts on that? And do you think it's too soon?
Taylor Swift is known for winning over the mum, and I think I'm a Swiftie. I love Taylor. I'm going to the concert. I've been to her concerts before, so no dissing Taylor, but she gets in there quick with the mums, and I think it's smart. It also plays into her really wholesome persona that she has. I don't think it's that early. I think Taylor does a lot of secret, low-key dating, and then she lets it go out to the public. So I reckon they've been a thing for a while.
But I also think it's a good thing to get in early. You want to know, like, especially in heterosexual relationships, is he a mummy's boy? Does mummy do everything for him? Does she cook? Does she clean? Because that sets the precedent of what he's going to expect in the relationship, I think.
But that's Maddie Day. Maddie Day's mum's amazing.
I have my husband well-trained. He is phenomenal. But his mum is also amazing.
Now, I've got some issues in my own personal dating life. I was wondering if you guys could help me. My beautiful girlfriend, Julieta, she's enforcing a new policy that we have to, each night when we go to sleep, we have to swap sides of the bed. So neither of us have a side for our own at the moment. I haven't had a good night's sleep in 6 months. What do I do? Help me.
You're dating a psychopath. Oh, end the relationship. You are out of there. Nobody, no sane person changes the bed. You have your side for life.
That's what I've been telling her.
Has she given you a reason? Did she say, like, what was the instigator for this?
Keep it spicy.
She just wants to have a bit of fun.
A bit of fun? Is that the idea of fun?
Guys, I know that they say change is as good as a holiday, but I just maybe take a weekend away. I couldn't think of anything worse than swapping sides. I'd feel so disorientated.
But
I wouldn't
Sam,
know where I am.
We always come to you with an idea to rectify the problem. That's what we do at Life Uncut. So my idea would be, hey, why don't we meet a quarter of the way, not halfway, but when we go on holiday, hotels, staycations, we'll switch it up then. But like that's the day to day through the week, or maybe it's a Saturday, like a fun night out, like you have a dinner and then you swap Saturday.
Well, look, it might not be a problem. She might leave me after watching this, so we might not have to worry about it much longer.
Well, you can hear the girls on their Life Uncut podcast, and all the info on how to catch them live is on our website. Britt and Laura, thanks so much for chatting.
Thank you.
Was that your attempt to get out of proposal?
Yeah, well, I didn't want her to be called a psychopath.
Good luck with this proposal.